Now we are going to take up a problem that involves combined translational motion and rotational motion. A bowling ball is thrown with a velocity v0. It is initially not rotating. That means the angular velocity omega naught is equal to 0. After moving with kinetic friction along the lane for a distance capital D, it finally rose without slipping and has a new velocity v. We have to find the final velocity of the ball. Now, finally it is rolling without slipping. That means it is in pure rolling. The condition for pure rolling is v equal to r omega. This problem can be solved by two methods. The first method is by studying the translational motion and the rotational motion of the ball independently. The link between translational motion and rotational motion is time. This time will be common. The second method of solving this problem is by conserving angular momentum about the point of contact A. The net torque about point A is zero. Therefore, the angular momentum of the ball will remain constant. First, let us solve this problem by studying the translational motion and rotational motion of the ball. If you look at the translational motion of the ball, the initial velocity is v0. Right? And the final velocity is v. The acceleration is due to the frictional force, and acceleration will be given by minus f by m. The time taken is say t. So v is equal to u plus at. So v becomes v0 minus f by m into t. This is the equation that we get by studying the translational motion of the ball. Now let us look at the rotational motion of the ball. The initial angular velocity is 0. The ball was not rotating initially. The final angular velocity, omega, is v upon r, because now it is rolling without slipping, or is it pure rolling. The torque, which is force into perpendicular distance, the frictional force is acting here, the torque about this point will be f into r, and that is I alpha, torque equal to I alpha. So alpha becomes fr by I. The moment of inertia of a solid sphere is 2 by 5 mr square. So 1 r cancels out. So we get the moment of inertia as 2 by 5 mr square and alpha as 5f by 2m r. So alpha is 5f by 2mr. Now we can use the equation omega equal to omega naught plus alpha t. Omega is v upon r, omega naught is 0, alpha is 5f by 2mr, and time is t. So we can solve for time. This r cancels out, time becomes 2mv by 5f. So this is the time that we get by studying the rotation motion. Now we can substitute this time and get the final velocity. So V is V naught minus F by M into the time t, which is 2mv by 5f. So F cancels out, M also cancels out, V becomes V naught minus 2 by 5 V. So take this side, V becomes 5 by 7 V naught. And that is the answer. The final velocity of the ball will be 5 by 7 V naught. Now this same problem can be solved easily by conserving angular momentum about point A. The angular momentum of a body which is in combined translation and rotation motion is given by L equal to LCM plus M R naught cross V naught. Okay, where R naught is the position vector of the center of mass and V naught is the velocity of the center of mass. If you look at the initial angular momentum here, the initial angular momentum will be the initial angular momentum of about the center of mass is given by I omega naught plus M, radius is capital R and the velocity of the center of mass is V naught. Now omega naught is 0, so initial angular momentum is just MR V naught. Look at the final angular momentum. The final angular momentum of the center of mass will be like I omega. And you will get M R V, because the final velocity of the center of mass is V. Now by conservation of angular momentum, Li will be Lf. We are able to conserve angular momentum because the net torque about point A is 0. Therefore, MRV naught will be equal to I omega plus MRV. The moment of inertia of a solid sphere is given by 2 by 5 MR square. So MRV naught plus 2 by 5 MR square omega plus MRV. So M cancels from everywhere, 1 R cancels, V naught becomes 2 by 5 into V, because R omega is V, plus V. So V equal to R omega, that is the condition for pure rolling. We solve this, we get again V equal to 5 by 7 V naught. So the same problem can be solved by two methods. One is by studying the translational motion of the ball and the rotational motion of the ball independently. Time is the link between them. And the second method is by conservation of angular momentum about point A.